Getting started with Luminar with libraries is easy. The first thing you need to do after you have launched the application is to add some photos. Click on the plus sign in the right side of the panel next to the word folders. Navigate to a folder of images on your computer, perhaps a recent vacation. Select the folder and click the Add Folder button. Luminar quickly generates thumbnails of all the photos in that folder. You can change the size of the thumbnails with the magnification controls in the toolbar. Now, all you need to do is pick an image to edit. I like this panorama. I'm going to select it, and now in the upper right-hand corner of the interface, I'm going to click on the word Edit to switch from the library view to the edit view. Luminar has workspaces that lets you quickly load just the right filters you need to edit your photo. I'm going to choose Quick and Awesome. The Quick and Awesome workspace loads four filters: Accent AI, AI Sky Enhancer, Saturation and Vibrance, and Clarity. The Accent AI filter analyzes your image using artificial intelligence. As you move the slider to the right, it fixes shadows and highlights, exposure, contrast, and a lot more. But all you need to know is to move the slider to the right until you like the way your picture looks. The AI Sky Enhancer also uses artificial intelligence to give you beautiful skies almost instantly. It recognizes what's sky and what's not sky. Notice as I move the slider to the right, only the sky is affected. It's smart enough to know not to change the water or the blue houses at the bottom of the image. I really like the Vibrance slider in the Saturation and Vibrance filter. Vibrance is smart saturation, only increasing the saturation of the more muted colors, giving a more natural pop to the color in the image. With vibrance and saturation, a little goes a long way. And finally, let's add a hint of clarity to punch up the detail. I think I want to add one more filter. Adding a filter is as simple as clicking the Add Filter button, which opens the filters catalog. Luminar has over 50 filters to choose from to meet all of your developing needs. I'm going to add a second AI Sky Enhancer filter to really make my skies pop. All I have to do is simply click, and the filter is applied to my image. And now, move the slider to the right until the sky looks exactly how I want it. And finally, I'm going to add the Foliage Enhancer filter to tweak the color and saturation of the trees. Feel free to play with all of the filters. You can always reset a filter under the drop-down menu below each filter's name, and delete a filter simply by clicking the small X to the right of its name. To close the filter's catalog, click on the Add Filters button again. If you want to see a before and after version of your photo, there's a quick preview on the top toolbar. The eyeball icon quickly toggles between the original image and your edited version. You can really see the difference between the before and after. Next to the quick preview button is the compare button, which lets you do a split screen comparison between your before and your after image. Click on the compare button again to turn it off. Now, if you want, you can select another photo to process from the film strip on the left side of the interface. Or if you want to go back to the full library view, click the Navigate Up button on the toolbar. To export a finished photo, simply go to the File menu and choose Export. In the pop-up, you can rename your photo, select where you want to save it, and select what format you want to save it in, and click Save. Making beautiful photos in Luminar is that easy.